If you didn't know it by now, there's going to be a brand new, completely redesigned Nissan Frontier for 2021. This is not that truck. This is a 2020 Nissan Frontier. And for 2020, Nissan has done something a little unexpected, and they've actually given this a refresh. They've pulled a page out of Ford's playbook and given us an entirely new engine and transmission under the hood. That's the really big news for 2020. That's the same engine and transmission that we'll be able to drive in the 2021 Frontier. So if you're wondering how that 2021 Frontier is going to pull, this is really going to give you a good idea of that right up front. And then on the inside, we have a few standard features that we didn't have before, like standard power windows, standard power door locks, and push button start availability. Since the big change happens under the hood, let's talk about that first. This is an all new 3.8 liter direct injected V6 engine. It's going to produce 310 horsepower, and this is the only engine available for 2020. So it's the base engine, it's also the upgraded engine, and the big thing to know about that is that this produces more power than most of the optional engines in the compact truck segment, significantly more power than the base engines that we find in things like the Toyota Tacoma. This engine is mated now to a 9-speed automatic transmission that has nearly double the gear ranges that we found in the outgoing model. And I'm not just talking about the number of gears itself, I'm talking about the distance between them. So we have a much more aggressive first gear and a much taller final gear, improving not only acceleration, but also fuel economy in the process. We're also told to expect some towing improvements, and fuel economy should be at least 9% higher than the optional engine that was available in the Frontier before. This is again going to be the same engine and transmission combination that we will find in the 2021 Frontier when it is finally released. I have to say that personally, I was a little bit surprised that 3.8 is the displacement that Nissan went for, because that makes this engine larger in displacement than really every other entry in this segment. The Jeep Gladiator, for instance, has a 3.6 liter engine. The Ford Ranger has a 2.3 liter turbo, and Toyota's pickup trucks, of course, have a 3.5. So I'm a little bit surprised that Nissan decided to go so powerful and pretty torquey in this generation. Now on the inside, we have essentially no changes aside from this start-stop button right down there in the center console, because we do have keyless go. We also have a leather-wrapped shifter in all models. That is kind of a nice touch, but the rest of the Frontier's interior definitely feels a little bit old school. Now I'm a little bit conflicted on that, because I find the retroness of this interior attractive in sort of a strange way. This interior is definitely getting old. When you take a look at the dashboard as you pan around here, you'll notice that the steering wheel definitely feels like it's out of a different era. The steering column shape definitely feels like it's out of a different time as well. Tiny screen right there in the dashboard. It has been updated over time to give us more modern features, but the overall shapes of the dashboard just feel like they're out of a different era of Nissan. But it's brand new, and there's some sort of nostalgia going on there about that. The Frontier is also an incredible deal. This is one of the least expensive trucks in America. So if you're looking for a great engine and just a very inexpensive work truck, this is a great, great option, especially now that we have that brand new 9-speed automatic transmission. It is basically the same 9-speed that we find in the Titan, so it should be pretty durable because it was designed for that large V8. Between the front seats, we find two huge cup holders right there with removable dividers and a little bit of extra storage space right there on the center console, but it's obvious that this is a smaller truck. Overall room in the back seat is pretty decent, and I have to say that compared to something like the Toyota Tacoma, the Frontier is still relatively comfortable. The Tacoma really hasn't changed in a long time either in terms of its overall design, and the seating position in here is relatively similar to that Toyota. A lot of truck people that I know argue that the Nissan Frontier is one of the best deals in the truck segment. It's solid, it's been reliable, it hasn't been a lot. A number of truck people that I know think that the Nissan Frontier is one of the best truck values available in America. It certainly has one of the lowest base prices. And for 2020, it definitely has become more attractive as we wait for the all-new 2021 Frontier. That's probably why the Frontier still sells pretty darn well in this segment overall. It doesn't sell quite as well as the Toyota Tacoma, but it certainly outsells a decent number of other options in America. And of course, you can get an off-road Pro 4X version if you want to. Be sure and hit that subscribe button down there at the bottom of your screen, because hopefully we will be driving this with this new engine just as soon as possible, and we will certainly be driving the 2021 just as soon as that model comes out. Be sure to check out the rest of our coverage from the 2020 Chicago Auto Show, and hit that subscribe button down there if you haven't already done so. I'll see you all later.